about Van Gogh. It's about the potato eaters. And I think more than that, it's about Vincent.
I was expressing the usual interest in the peasants, the working people, the underprivileged. And I'm trying to portray them as realistically as I could, but in the manner of previous Dutch painters. So he used these very dark blue colours, partly because they were traditional colours in art, but also because they showed what it was like in the interior of one of those houses. And he was just trying to emphasize the vestigial vision of their poverty.
Early development as a painter, but initially had to explore further, to expose himself to new influences, new ideas, new visions. It would be a short, friendly journey that would lead to work of genius and a life of torment. By November 1885, Van Gogh already suspected that his time was running out. That month, he left his family in Holland. Over the following 56 months, he created his legend. Vincent arrived in the Belgian world for the study of art piano, but he also sought out his own influence. Antwerp was, and remains, home to many works by the Flemish master Peter Paul Rubens. Van Gogh was especially impressed with Rubens' bold handling of colour, and we can see the influence of Rubens in this portrait of a woman, painted shortly after Van Gogh's arrival in Antwerp.
Japanese subject, but the style of Japanese, he uses the diagonals. He uses areas of colour enclosed by not necessarily a clear outline. One colour is clearly differentiated from another, so you have patches of colour. And the whole thing is very tightly pulled together. With attention, some attention to detail, he has the exact shape of the colours in the most incredibly decorative fashion. But I think he just responded of decoration, combined with love of detail and an overall particular kind of tense, taut composition. It's because of this that he responded so strongly to Japanese.
Van Gogh's passion for Japanese art would stay with him when he tired of life in Antwerp. In March 1886, Theo Van Gogh was surprised to receive a message at the Japanese branch of Goupil's, where he was. It was from his brother, and I think that he was at the Louvre, awaiting Theo's arrival. Vincent Van Gogh had come to Paris, and it was here that his greatness as an artist began. Though his arrival was sudden, Vincent had written to his brother, explaining his desire to come to the center of European artistic life. His plan was to study the chief
time to speak in a peculiar way.
Thank you.